same day I got a call from Dublin, imagine, you know. So I was confused if this is some kind of scam or, you know, if it is, this is a fake call. So I was always asking about how much should I pay, how much. And then they were like, you don't have to pay anything. If you're interested to migrate to Ireland.
So the very first thing is, can you tell the audience, when did you move to Ireland and how many years of medical experience do you have?
I have almost 5 years of nursing experience, and I moved to Ireland, came here in March actually.
So what are the different ways one can apply if they want to migrate to Ireland?
Since I'm in the medical field, I know more about the medical thing. I know nurses can migrate after they appear for OET and get the required score. They can come as registered nurses. Apart from that, I've heard a few, like, we can come and do our studies here in student visa also.
Now, you mentioned OET exam. So what exactly is OET exam? And what are the cutoff requirements for this exam?
OET exam is specifically for medical professionals, because the more kind of language they use is related to medical field. So it will be more easier for, like, nurses and doctors when they appear for the exam, especially during the speaking, listening and all. They get to hear all the recordings from, for example, if it's a listening, they get to hear recordings between a doctor and a patient. And so it is more familiar to them. So I think for medical profession, it's more easier because it's more about all medical field. There are four modules, reading, listening, writing and speaking. When I came in, you had to get a B score in writing and speaking, and you can you could get through with a C plus in listening and reading. But now, I think since April 2020, they have changed it. They have made it like you can get a C plus in writing, but you need to have B in the other three modules. That's what I think. I'm not very sure about the new rules, but I think you can get a better idea if you can check the NMBI website. NMBI, the Nursing and Midwifery Board of Ireland website, states clearly about the new the updates.
Now, once you've cleared the OET exam, what is the next step in the application process?
Once you've got the required score, you need to log into the NMBI website, the Nursing and Midwifery Board of Ireland website, and you can see we have to download an application form for requisition for the application pack. So that form, you have to fill it out and you have to give your credit card details, and they'll deduct an amount. I don't remember the exact, I think it was, I'm not sure about the amount, I'm so sorry. So we have to fill out our credit card details, and it should be sent by post to the address given in that application form itself. So we'll get a response within 1 or 2 weeks. They'll deduct the amount from your credit card. And then within 5 days, I got the link in my email. Before, it was all postal. So when I started applying, they sent the link to the email, and I could just log into the website and download my application pack. So it's more easier now. Before, we had to wait for the postal thing, like postal to come, and it would take longer time. I think it's more easier now, no more faster.
Now, how long does the entire migration process take, and how much does it cost?
For me, it took around 6 to 9 months. For me, I actually applied for a job in the beginning in Ireland without even thinking about registering in with the NMBA. So when I just send my CV to one of the agencies, so they accepted, seeing my experience in the UAE, they accepted and they gave me a call back, and they asked me if I could attend the interview. So after I cleared the interview, then only I started my process with the NMBA. I think most of the candidates, they do it the other way. They start the registration with the NMBI. Then they start looking for jobs. They can look for jobs through various agencies, like, for example, IITR in India, CPL, which is based in Dublin here. So they can just go into the websites and start looking for an employer. Finding an employer is very necessary before you come into Ireland. So they are the one who are supposed to give you an offer letter, and then that's how we get the visa and all. So regarding the cost, for me, it was all paid from from my employer. I got a job in a public hospital. So I got even my visa cost, the NMBA application fees, everything reimbursed. And even the tickets were booked from my employer side. As far as I know, if you want to come to Ireland, you need to find an employer before you can get into Ireland. You need to show the offer letter, everything, when you go for a visa application. It differs individually. Actually, it depends on your experience and all, and how fast the authorities get back to the NMBA. It all depends on that. And there are people who have who still wait for 1 year and all. It still takes it's a long process. Depends on your experience.
So when it comes to nursing as a profession, people often get confused between UK and Ireland. So why did you choose Ireland?
Actually, I didn't have an option to choose between UK and Ireland. I had a few friends who were working here. And when I got the opportunity, I happily decided to take that opportunity. That's what happened with me. I saw a few pics of my friends here, and I felt it's a very beautiful and peaceful country to live in. So that's why I decided to take Ireland.
Now, in terms of salary bracket, what is the rough salary which is offered to professionals in the nursing field in Ireland?
I think it's from 34,000 to 45,000 per annum. That's just a rough amount, depending on an experience.
Now, when you immigrated, did you go through an agency or did you do the entire process by yourself?
The agency I came in through is named as CPL. I just sent my CV to CPL, stating my experience and all. So they gave me a call back on the same day, saying that they have few openings for this experience. So they let me choose between two or three hospitals, even that. So they even started explaining about the hospitals and the kind of salaries they are giving. They helped me to choose between public and private hospitals. They were really helpful. And the fee was there was nothing I should pay. It was all free. So when I got a job, when I got a call back, I was I really asked them if I should pay anything, because I was really... when I sent my CV to CPL and they gave me a call on the same day, I got a call from Dublin, imagine, So I was confused if this is some kind of scam or if this is a fake call. So I was always asking about how much should I pay, how much. And then they were like, you don't have to pay anything. If you're interested to migrate to Ireland, then just we are going to forward your CV to our employer and we'll let you know if you cannot, if they are happy to give you an opportunity to attend an interview. So that's what happened with me. I didn't have to pay anything.
Considering that you have been living in Ireland for the last couple of months, what do you think of the weather and the lifestyle in Ireland?
I came in March and it was the starting of summer. That's what people said, but it was still quite freezing for me. Towards April, May and June was a little bit warmer it was more comfortable and sunny. It was a good time to go out. And now it's getting more winter again from October. It's still very cold. And people say it's going to be even more harder when it gets to December, January. So it's, I think, 6 months. It's 6 months. It's from April to October, it's a good time to go around and see places. And also after October, it will be winter and we'll have to stay indoors more.
And finally, one tip which you would want to give to all the viewers who are planning of migrating to Ireland as a nurse.
One thing I found it difficult was when I got my application pack, and in the application pack, there are a few sections that need to be filled out by your previous employers and your previous registration authorities. For example, if I worked in India and I had a registration from Tamil Nadu, and I worked in Abu Dhabi, I had a registration from the Abu Dhabi Health Authority. So I had to get forms filled up from them. And then the NMBA was very particular that they wanted all in post. So getting it all in a post is very difficult because most of them prefer to do it in an email. So that was a big problem with me. So I had to mail NMBA saying that this the authorities they are going to send it through an email and not by post. And in the beginning, they were not accepting it, the NMBA. And they wanted it through post with the original document with the signed signature and the seal, everything. They wanted it as a paper. So that was a hurdle for me. And I had to like follow up with them. And then I had to send a lot of mails to the NMBA regarding that. Anyway, finally they accepted. I think now they are accepting emails, forms, the soft copy of the forms.
So Anu, thank you again for taking out your time. It was great having you on this show. And thank you again for sharing all these valuable points with the audience.
Thank you, Nikhil. Thank you. Nice talking to you as well.